Please subscribe our channel Education Point and press bell icon to get notification of new educational videos.
Hello everyone, you are all welcome to lecture number 194, and here I am going to discuss the various methods of ore dressing. Ore dressing means here the method by means of which we are removing all type of dirty impurities, that is called gangue or matrix, with the help of several methods. So first, the simplest method, the one like stone, like log or some other material which are very much visible, we can do by hand picking. That is called by hand picking. And then some other processes are coming, like we are using froath floatation method, means we will powder it and then we will just stir it in presence of oil, so there will be formation of foaming. So we will use the foaming agent like turpentine oil, so that foam is separated in the form of pure metals. Then electromagnetic method, where on the electromagnetic belt we will be putting the powder of all those impure ores, and the magnet will be pulling the magnetic particles towards itself, and the non-magnetic ferrous pure particles will go to other sides. So these are all methods, they are discussed here, so one by one. So the process of removing gangue or matrix, that is non-metallic and rocky materials such as quartz, mica, feldspars and silicates from metal ores is known as ore dressing. The following methods are given below. Number one is, that is hand picking. The gross lumps of rocks may be removed from the ore by simple hand picking. Number two is, that is known as hydraulic washing, that is, or levigation, hydraulic washing or levigation. This method is based on the difference in the densities of the gangue mineral particles. The gravity separation is usually carried out by using wheel fly or hydraulic classifier. This instrument or machine is used to separate on the basis of densities of gangue and ore. Number three, that is froth flotation method. I told you that this process is especially suitable for the concentration of low grade ores such as sulfide ores. The process is based on the different wetting characteristic of the ore and gangue particles with water and oil. So with water and oil, these two immiscible liquid phase, with that there will be froth flotation. The crushed sulfide ore is treated with water to form pulp or slurry. This is introduced in a tank and then more water is added. Now the foaming agent such as pine oil together with a little lime or sodium carbonate is added to the flotation tank. The ore like copper pyrite, that is CuFeS2, or galena, that is PbS, and zinc blended, that is ZnS, are purified by making use of froth flotation method. Number four, that is magnetic concentration method. This process is used in the case of ferromagnetic ores such as iron, tin stone. The process is used when the mineral is attracted by magnet. Number five, that electromagnetic separation. That is, I told you, on the belt, magnet is put and the powder is allowed to move. The magnetic attracted particle will come to that side where the roller is magnetic, and the other one will pass on to other side. This method is used for separating ore from magnetic impurities. The tin stone ore is separated from magnetic impurities by this method. So here in ore dressing method, now I'm going to discuss some chemical reactions, how these chemical reactions are involved in the extraction of metals to purify from the gangue and impurities. So first is known as calcination. First reaction is calcination. In the calcination reaction, the calcination is a chemical process in which the ore is subjected to the action of heat at high temperature in absence of air. The process of calcination is carried out in the case of carbonates and hydrates. So those ores which are carbonate and hydrates, they are subjected to calcination process, and they are like that. The first one, when limestone is heated, this is your limestone. When it is heated at high temperature, you will get calcium oxide, and the carbon dioxide will escape. Second ore is, that is magnesite, MgCO3. Here carbon dioxide will escape, you will get MgO. The third one, that is MgCO3, CsO3, that is called dolomite. The ore name is dolomite. When it is subjected to calcination, you will get MgO plus calcium oxide plus 2CO2 gas will escape in atmosphere. Then the fourth one is, that is hydroxide, that is CuCO3 plus CuOH twice, that is known as malachite. And this malachite, when it is heated, you will get copper oxide, water, and plus CO2 will escape. Then ZnCO3, that is calamine, the old name is calamine. And here in this calcination process, ZnO will be there and carbon dioxide will be splitted off. Then the last one is, that is your limestone, Fe2CO3 plus 3H2O, and it will give you 2Fe2O3 plus 3H2O will escape in atmosphere. Then number second is, that is called roasting. In the process of roasting, the ore either alone or with addition of suitable mineral is subjected to heat action. Roasting is usually is carried out in furnace. During roasting, the volatile impurities like sulfur, AS, SB get in the form of oxide gases, and they are evaporated like SO2, AS2O3 and SbO3. Number three is, that is smelting. Smelting, it is the process used for all operation where the metal is separated by fusion. They are fused together from the ore. For example, hematite ore, that is Fe2O3, is smelted with coke, that is carbon, and limestone, that is CsO3, and then it will form the flux. As a result of reduction, iron is obtained in molten state. So reaction is given here, that is hematite Fe2O3, when it is treated with coke, that is 3C, you will get 2Fe. So Fe is found in molten state. Then calcium carbonate is heated, and that will give you CO and CO2. Then again Fe2O3, that is hematite, is treated with 3CO, you will get 2Fe plus 3CO2 will escape. And here CO is flux, SiO2 is gangue, and this one will give CaSiO3, that is your slag. So with this I will stop here. Thank you very much.